Question 35. An electric cable consists of 7 strands of copper wire. Sounds like the beginning of a Christmas carol. Anyway, 7 strands of copper wire, each of diameter this much, connected in parallel. Okay, they're very helpful. Whenever you have strands of wire that you wound together, it is definitely a parallel connection. Okay, so let me try and see if I can find a drawing to help you visualize this. Okay, so your 7 strands of copper wire in parallel will be like this. Because whatever current that passes through, let's say a current passed through this strand, it will not have to pass through, let's say, this strand. Aya, it's like you have 7 roads. So you don't have to go through all 7 of them. One of them is good enough. They are not connected in series. But you know what? They give you already. So treat it as it is lah. Resistivity of copper is given like this. The current in the cable is this. Okay. What is the potential difference between 2 points on the cable of a distance 1 meter apart? So we got diameter, we got length. Alright, to find potential difference, V equal to IR. Remember, one equation to rule them all. But you see, I need to find R first. Because I don't have R. So at the same time, R is equal to rho L over A. Okay, so now let's see. I can do rho L over A for one wire. One copper wire. Okay, so I'm going to do this. 1.72 times 10 to the power of negative 8. The length of the copper wire that you are measuring the potential difference of is 1 meter. Divide by area, which is pi d square over 4. So 0.30 times 10 to the power of negative 3 square divide by 4. Okay, so if you press your calculator for this one, I believe you will get 0.243 ohm. But this is one copper wire. We have 7 copper wire in parallel. So if it's 7 copper wire in parallel, then I will need to take 1 over total resistance is 1 over 0.243 plus 1 over 0.243 plus 1 over 0.243. Can I just multiply by 7? Because you're going to do this 7 times, right? So times 7. So your total resistance is actually 0.243 divided by 7, which is 0.0347. Okay, it's objective, so you don't have to be very accurate anyway. So V is equal to IR. We have current, 13 amps. We have resistance, 0.0347. They are not meant to be big to begin with. So if you multiply by 13, this will give you 0.45 volt. The answer will then be C. Okay, I mean, it's not insignificant, but it is a 1 meter long cable. So when you do an experiment, the less cable you use, the better. Because this is lost volts that you cannot retrieve and it will create errors in your reading. But yeah, pretty straightforward. If it's parallel, treat it this way. All cables is parallel unless I connect the copper wire like this lah, wire one. And then I connect like this to wire 2. So this one would be series. Okay? But currently what they are doing is several wires together. This is parallel. Okay? So if you want to try out a similar question from past years, I have one, the one that I stole this diagram from. You can try right here. Try May, June 13, paper 1-3, question 34. Okay? May, June 13, paper 1-3, question 34. Okay, that's it. Pretty straightforward. Cables and resistance.